हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आई एम हुसैन जान, फिज़िक्स लेक्चरर एट APS जमजमा नौशेरा कैंट, एंड आई टीच यू क्लास 8 फिज़िक्स। वी आर इन यूनिट 2 काइनेमेटिक्स। फॉरवर्ड, वी आर इन यूनिट 2 विच इज़ काइनेमेटिक्स, एंड वी विल डिस्कस इक्वेशंस ऑफ मोशन विच इंक्लूड फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन, सेकेंड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन and third equation of motion. Now, at the end of this lecture, the students are expected that they should derive the equation of motion for a body moving with uniform acceleration and in a straight line while using the graph. That they should use the graph to derive these equations of motion, which will be covered in this lecture. But the motion will be uniformly accelerated and should be along the straight line. These are two basic assumptions which will be considered while deriving the equations of motion. So, moving forward, what are the equations of motion? These are the equations which relate the initial velocity, final velocity of body, initial velocity of body, final velocity of body, which will be denoted with Vf, uniform acceleration, which will be denoted with A, time taken by the body, which will be denoted by T, and distance covered by the body, which will be denoted by S in the rest of the lecture while deriving the equations of motion. So, first equation of motion, which is Vf is equal to Vi plus At. We have already discussed that which type of symbol should be used for which type of quantity. So for this, in order to derive this equation, consider a body which is moving with initial velocity Vi in a straight line, first assumption, and with uniform acceleration, second assumption. So both these assumptions should be considered in each and every equation of motion. So since we are using graphical method, so using these assumption and this type of condition, we can plot the graph for the body moving with uniform acceleration. Since the acceleration is uniform, so the graph will be a straight line. It must be a straight line. Second, body is moving with initial velocity, so there must be some velocity. And after some time, the velocity of the body change, so it will not be the same as initial velocity. It will be changed to final velocity, which will be Vf, not Vi. After time, this one. Now, in order to derive this equation, over here we have Vf, Vi, acceleration and time. So it means we have the relation between final velocity, initial velocity, acceleration and time. So for this, we know that the slope of the speed time graph gives us acceleration. So it means if we find the slope of the speed time graph, this is speed time graph, so it will give us acceleration. So for this, slope of AB line, the graph is actually this line, so AB line is equal to, the slope of AB line is equal to acceleration. And if we consider, if we make a triangle from this line, which will be this and this line, if we draw these two lines, it will be just like a triangle. Now, to find the slope of this line, we have to divide this line, which is perpendicular in this triangle, by this line, which is base in this triangle. So over here, BC divided by AC. BC divided by AC. Now it can be this line. So this line is actually equal to BD line, this total line, minus DC line. So if we subtract this portion from this total line, we will be left with BC line, this one. So it means this line is actually equal to this total line minus this portion. So BD, this one, minus CD. Now AC, this is AC line. So this line is actually equal to OD line. Both are same and equal. So we can use OD in place of AC. Right? Now we are now identifying the quantities which are related to the motion and represented by these lines, which is BD and CD. Now BD line actually over here is, it represents the final velocity. This line, both are same, this line and this line are same, and this is final velocity. So it means we can write VF in place of BD line. Similarly CD line, this BD line will be equal to VF. Similarly CD line, this one, this is CD line. Now this CD line is actually representing the initial velocity. So CD equal to initial velocity. Now OD line, OD line is representing the time. So OD is equal to time. Now just putting the values in this equation, just putting these quantities in this equation, we will get acceleration, which is this one. BD is actually VF, so we can write the VF in place of this. CD is equal to VI, so we can write VI. OD is equal to T, so we can write T. Now just rearranging by cross multiplication, this time will be multiplied by A. So AT is equal to VF minus VI. Now we can rearrange this equation, VI can be shifted to the right, so it will be left with VF, VI over here, and AT. So this is the first equation of motion, which says that final velocity will be equal to initial velocity plus acceleration multiplied by time. So if you multiply the acceleration with time and add this with the initial velocity, it will give us final velocity of the body. Now moving toward the second equation of motion, which is S is equal to VIT plus half AT square. Now if you look over here, there is S, and we have already said that S is the distance covered by the body. So we make, it means that we need to find S, we need to find the formula for S. So for this we consider the graph, the same graph, same situation, same uniform acceleration, same initial velocity, right? Now what will we do if we have speed time graph and we have to find the distance covered by the body? We have already discussed that if we have speed time graph of the body and we need to find the distance covered by the body, we have to calculate the area under the graph. Now over here we need to calculate the area, which is this shaded area. This is area under this line. The area under the graph is actually the area between the graph and the horizontal axis. So this is the area which will be calculated in order to find distance covered by the body. Now how to calculate, the question arises, how to calculate this area? So for this we divide this area into rectangular shape, which is this one, and triangular shape, which is this one, right? So It means that if we calculate this area and we add this, it will give us the distance covered by the body. So for this, in order to calculate this area, total distance is equal to area of triangle plus area of rectangle and area of triangle. Now we already know that what is the formula to find the area of triangle. So if we multiply this length with this length or this length with this length, both are same, so it will give us the area of this rectangle. So for this, moving forward, to find the area of rectangle, we have to multiply OA with OD. Now OA over here is actually initial velocity, the magnitude of initial velocity, and OD over here is the time taken. So if you multiply VI with time, it will give us the area of this rectangle. Now similarly, if we find the area of the triangle, so what will we do? We will multiply this with this, multiply this AC with BC and divide by 2, because it is the half of the rectangular area. If we multiply this line with this, it will give us the area of rectangle. Since it is the half, it is divided by, so it will be divided by 2, right? So it means AC multiply by BC, AC multiply by BC and divide by 2. Now AC over here is actually equal to OD, so we can write T in place of AC, right? Now what about BC? BC they write 80. So how this BC is equal to 80? For this, we know that slope is equal to acceleration. Slope of speed time graph is equal to acceleration. Now to find the slope, we have already calculated BC, this line, divided by AC. Right? Now AC over here is actually OD. So AC is equal to OD is equal to time. So it means in place of AC, in this equation we can write time. So A is equal to BC divided by T. If we multiply this time with A, we will be left with BC. So BC is equal to 80. That is why BC is equal to 80. Right? Just putting this and this in this equation, area of rectangle plus area of triangle, so if we add this, it will give us VIT plus half T multiplied by AT. So T and T is anywhere they are multiplied, bases are same, so power will be added whenever base are same and they are multiplied, so power will be added. So we will get S is equal to VIT plus half AT square. This is the second equation of motion. Moving forward to the third equation of motion, over here we will relate acceleration, distance covered, final velocity and initial velocity of the body. So for this, again the same graph will be used. Over here the same graph is here. Now again here there is distance, so it means we need to calculate the area under the graph. Now if you look at the graph, this is trapezium. The total area under the graph is trapezium, and we know that to find the area of trapezium, it is equal to the sum of the parallel side. This side and this side are parallel, so the sum of parallel side divided by 2, sum of parallel side divided by 2 and multiplied by the perpendicular side or this side, base, right? So we get this formula. Now just putting the quantities represented by these lines, we will get the equation. So this two will be multiplied to this side, or you can cross multiply. This will be 2s is equal to OA plus BD multiplied by 4D, the same is pasted. Now if we look at the equation over here, this is 2AS. Now 2S is here, but there is no A, there is no acceleration. Now we already know that if we find the slope of this, we will be left with acceleration, we will get acceleration. And in order to find the slope, it will be equal to BC divided by AC. It means that if we multiply BC by AC to this side, if we multiply BC by AC, actually AC over here is equal to OD, so you can write AC or OD, both are same. So if we multiply the ratio of BC and OD to the left side, we will get acceleration, because BC over AD is equal to acceleration. So if we multiply this, we will get acceleration, right? So for this, if we multiply BC over OD to this side, to maintain equality, we will also multiply BC over OD to this side. So for this, BC over OD is multiplied over here, and it is also multiplied over here. Now BC over AD is equal to acceleration, so we will get 2S and A. This OD and this OD will be cancelled, so we will left 2S is equal to BC divided by OD is equal to OA plus BD multiplied by BC, this one. Now if we look at the graph, BC is equal to BC. BC is equal to, we have already discussed that BC can be written as BD, this total line, minus CD, this line. So if we subtract this portion from this total line, we will get this line. So BD minus DC or CD. Now BD is equal to VF, so we can write VF in place of BD. Similarly, DC, this one, it is equal to VI, so we can write VI in place of DC. The conclusion is that BC is equal to, this BC will be equal to VF minus VI. Now what about OA and BD? So OA over here is again VI, this one, and BD, we have already said that VF. So it means we can write VF plus VI multiplied by VF minus VI.
Just putting the values in equation 2.7, we get 2S multiplied by A is equal to VI plus VF multiplied by VF minus VI. It comes out to be 2AS is equal to VF square minus VI square. As we know that A plus B into A minus B is equal to A square minus B square, just using this formula, we will comes out to be 2AS is equal to VF square minus VI square. That's all. Thank you.